Who's gonna change? Who do you want to see? I think Robert Garcia will be a great fit.
He'll be a great trainer for Chavez. I don't know if Chavez would necessarily be a great fighter to train, though. You know, because I'm just judging by, you know, what I know about not showing up and things of that nature. And, you know, just me personally, that's not somebody I would have a desire to train. Not a trainer.
Yeah, but it also depends on the mood of the gym. Some gyms that you show up in, I don't feel. Some, you just can't wait to get back to the gym. And I think Robert has that in Oxnard, where people have such a good time, they just, they show up there and they stay there 6-7 hours.
Yeah, but still, as a trainer, if you have a fighter that, you know, has times when he doesn't want to give you maximum effort, you don't really have a desire.
Okay, because now the two rounds go through a switch each.
Then it is. Look, you know, if you got a fighter that is responsive to you and does what you tell him to do,
come up with a counter shot.
Because that is showing that he respects you and is taking in what you're saying. You want to work with that guy, but if you got somebody that just kind of is wishy-washy about whether or not they want to train, you don't really want to bother with them. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's like, you know, during the 24-7, you know, there's all the talk about, you know, oh, he missed a training camp day. He was late this day. You know, of course, you know, the weed smoking situation, of course. Which, me personally, I really don't give a shit about, you know, because...
He said he didn't smoke. He said someone gave him tea, and it was the leaves in the tea.
Well, whatever.
Jamaican tea or something. Come on.
Listen, in Amsterdam, they put it in the brownies, right?
It's a voodoo tea.
Maybe he's Dutch.
You know, a Mexican Dutch. Okay.
Could be.
But with Chavez, it's hard to say who's gonna train him. I do know that I read online that Chavez Jr. offered Nacho Beristain a certain sum of money. And from what I read online, Nacho said he didn't like the offer. And that, of course, I guess Chavez's camp said they would think about it, you know. And then who knows? Maybe Chavez is trying to look for a trainer that he's willing to give, that's willing to take what he's offering. And, of course, Nacho's not going to take what he's offering. Maybe Robert will. It's hard to say. I'll say this, though. If Chavez Jr. does train with Robert, goodbye of a Chavez Jr. versus Pavlik fight ever happening. Which I would like to see them fight. I think that would be a great matchup. You know, it's just that's the problem sometimes with certain fighters that can be a good matchup, have the same trainer. It's a fight that we'll never see. A lot of people were talking about Pacquiao and Amir Khan. I honestly think that would actually be a pretty good fight. I wouldn't mind seeing a fight.
Resets, please.
From what I understand, their sparring sessions were always awesome. There were times I heard Pacquiao got the better of Amir, and there were times that I heard that Amir got the better of Pacquiao. Their styles mesh, throw a lot of punches, and it would make for a much more interesting fight now because Amir Khan is with Virgil Hunter. He's no longer with Freddie Roach. And say if a Pacquiao versus Khan fight was to happen, there you go. Freddie is going in against one of his old fighters.
Right, but you have to remember, one fighter is the top ranked, one fighter is the Golden Boy, so we're probably not going to see that fight.
Unless... the chances of a Donaire Mares fight happening, it could probably clear the Cold War of that. But I think the only chances of Golden Boy fights versus top rank fights happening is when they do the purse bid. Good example. Vonis Martirosyan at Edris Landy Lara. The first time they fought, top rank won the bid. Now they're going to fight again, and Golden Boy has won the bid. So, you know, so it's like, what's going on? If y'all can win your bids and your fights, then...
Who wins that rematch? Vanes or Lara?
You know what? I'm probably going to get a lot of heat for this, but I honestly think Vanes wins the rematch. The technical draw in the first fight. The first fight, it was kind of lackluster, yeah. But Vanes was trying to press. He was trying to make the fight happen. Lara was doing what he does. Move, box, land a punch here and there, and move. That's what he was doing. Vanes was trying to... aggressive, land a straight right hand and land a left hook on him. That's what he was trying to do. Possibility the rematch could be better than the first fight now that they know each other's styles a lot better now because they've already been with each other. They know what they bring. But I know a lot of fans don't want to see the fight. But this is boxing. When fights get made, we're going to watch. Some of us may not, you know, I'm sure. But as a boxing fan, you're going to watch anything that gets made. Just like Malinachi Mosley, you know, that's been announced. I'm probably going to see it. Am I excited about it?
You can't stop talking about it. Of course you're going to see it.
I'll probably see it. But the bottom line is this. You know, fights getting made in boxing that we don't care about, that we don't want to see, but we'll end up watching them anyway, you know? Like Pacquiao Bradley. You know, people say, I'm not going to watch that. Well, some people did.
I want to see the rematch.
You know what? I would rather see Pacquiao rematch Bradley also. I don't really care too much about a fit fight with Marquez. If Pacquiao does come back, I think it's better that he comes back against somebody like Bradley. Try to get his win again over him. And also, some kind of tune-up. But I can also see why Freddie wants to take a fifth fight with Marquez. Because it's money. You know, why take a smaller check against Joe Schmo when you could go for the lottery against a name like Marquez? You know, it's boxing, it's a business. The fights get made. Are we gonna watch? Some of us will, some of us won't. But the bottom line is this, is that if you love the sport, you know you're gonna continue to follow it. You know you're gonna continue to watch it. And it's gonna be a part of your life, no matter whether you are in the ring or out of the ring. Being a fan of the sport is something that you're always gonna be into, definitely. So that's boxing, you know?